We are now going to use the driver once it has been installed and the printer being connected to your PC. I will use the USB connectivity, but the principle is exactly the same if you have a printer on the internet. So let's go to the driver. For this, you need to select Start, Settings, Printers and Faxes. You look where your icon or whatever is for the printer. It's this one. Select it and light it. So you right click on it, go into Properties, and there you will be presented with 7 tabs. So let's go with the simple one to discuss. The first one would be security. Here, for the user, whatever the user is, you need to have those 3 boxes ticked. If they are not, you will not be able to dialogue and send the print job to the printer. This is not really a Zebra issue, is more a Microsoft one. Second is sharing. In principle, you do not share the printer, which means that you have this selection over here, do not share the printer. You may select sharing the printer if, for example, you are a little bit short on IP addresses in your network, and the configuration will be to have a printer connected USB to your PC, for example, your PC connected to the network, and so your colleague through the network will be able to access the printer through your PC. So again, advantage here, you save 1 IP address, but evidently you will need to have always your PC connected for your colleague to access the printer. So in principle, leave it on do not share this printer. Port, here you need to have evidently a USB port ticked, and you can see here that it's connected to a Zebra ZXP printer. So in principle, I would say when this is done, you are able to dialogue. Please leave enable bidirectional support ticked. Let's go now on color management. Color management, we do not have so far official color profile, which means that when you are sending a print job, the colors from say the image you want to print will be sent directly to the printer, won't be modified at all, and the printer will print. In some cases, you might have a difference between the printed colors and the printer you can see on your monitor. There are ways in the driver, we will see them later on, to, I would say, modify a little bit that. But however, if you are not that satisfied, then there will be a need to create a color profile. This is done by engineering. And again, it's not done for the time being, but I suppose it will come sooner or later. And then you will have a color profile. For that, you'll just have to select manual over here. Click on add, point on your hard disk where the color profile is, and you'll just have to apply and click OK. So for the time being, as we do not have a color profile, leave it on automatic.